Hello, in this video I would like to show you different ways how to fuse your model images using the Emalytics preclinical software. Let me open the software first. We have here a CT scan with an organ segmentation and here's a PET scan after injection of FDG and you see signals in the heart and in the kidneys and in the eyes. However, the PET scan is not nicely aligned with the CT. So we can use the mouse mode interactive image fusion, it's here. And by default, you can move the overlay. So now I can shift it in this direction. When you go to the corner, the cursor changes and you can also rotate the PET data. However, we don't need it really in this case. So I will go back to the middle, the cursor changes and I can move the PET data here and can try to align it. You can also select that you want to move the underlay and the segmentation and you can place the CT here. But I recommend to use the overlay to shift it because it's easier. However, it's not a very accurate method, so more accurate is to use markers or the image intensities. And to show this, I will open another tutorial example dataset under General Image Fusion Load Example Dataset. It's here. I will rotate a little bit and switch off the segmentation. I will adjust the windowing of the overlay that you can see it better. And what we have here are basically two datasets of a mouse, and the mouse is in a different position in each. And now we would like to fuse them together as close as possible. And we can use the fusion model for this, it's here in the menu. And first we can perform some manual registration by adjusting the translation of the overlay, for example. So we go to Fusion, Overlay Transformation, Set Translation. You can see that all the values are zero. Now we shift it a little bit in the X direction by one. It goes in the Y direction, so a little bit further. Now we can also shift a little bit in the Z direction. That was the wrong direction, so minus one. And you see that it gets a little bit aligned. But a more accurate way is to use markers. And I will explain this in the next step. But by the way, what this manual registration does is it adjusts the transformation. So you can check it here under Options, Show Image Information. And here we have the values that we entered, 3 for X and minus 1 for Z. So it's not changing the rotation and it's also not changing the actual voxel values. So it's not resampling to a new grid. It just changes the geometric translation. Now I will undo this reset transform that I can show you the marker-based registration. Therefore I will place the markers on the underlay. That's why I will hide the overlay to focus on the underlay. So I go to the mouse action mode create marker. I will place I have to select the underlay. I will place some markers on the knees and on the elbows. Now I will hide the underlay and I will go to the overlay and place the markers on the same position there, but I will change the rendering from a volume rendering to an ISO rendering. That is easier to place markers there. By the way, you can also place markers on 2D, but in this case 3D is easier. So I place them also on the knees and on the elbows. Now I go back to the underlay, switch it on again, and now we can go to Fusion, which is the overlay to underlay computation translation markers. And now you see that unaligned overlay are nicely aligned. We can check out the image properties again. Therefore, I will go to the overlay. And what you can see here, it's changing the translation, also the rotation. The rotation is encoded here by this 3x3 matrix. And this fusion is an easy way when you have marker positions. You can also use the mouse pad. Let me change the window link a little bit that you can see it better. Here's some mouse pads, they have holes, and you can use these holes to place markers there. However, in some other cases, it may be better to perform fusion based on the image intensities. Therefore, I will undo the image fusion. I will delete the markers on the overlay and underlay. And what we need is a segmented region. So we can use scribble drawing and different slices to create a segmentation. However, we don't have to do this in this case because we have one segmentation, the one I hide at the beginning. So this region now is restricting our fusion to this area. Alternatively, you can restrict it also to the mouse bed, or you use the whole image space. So when you have defined a segmentation or a region, you can click on fusion, which is the overlay to underlay, compute rotation translation image based course. I have to select the segmentation A, this blue guy, as input class. So again, which is the overlay to underlay, compute rotation and translation image-based course, and it takes a few seconds, and then it's telling you the result and the root mean squared residual of the registration. And as you can see here, when I had the segmentation, it's now very nice aligned. And this course registration is relatively fast. It tries a few variations and picks the one with the best score. And when you have done that, you can fine-tune it using this menu item, which is the overlay to underlay, compute rotation translation image based fine. And now it's computing again, and then it will improve the current fusion. And now the fusion is even better, but it's hard to see because the alignment before was also really good. Okay. I hope this helps. Thank you and bye bye.